significant severe weather event this week. So I had two briefings today, one this morning, one this afternoon. They were both fairly similar. And so basically what we're looking at is Commissioner Weisenberg, the chairman, I were talking about some rain tonight. And that's not really the main event, so don't want people to think when they see some rain come through tonight and wake up in the morning and it's kind of died down, that they're in the clear, because the rain event is actually tomorrow around lunchtime, sometime between 11 and 1 o'clock time frame is the best time frame we can have. And so what they have developing is a warm front's moving through the area. It's going to cause a squall line to develop. The good thing, squall lines move through very quickly. So we're talking about maybe an hour event where we're pretty quick moving thunderstorm. The unfortunate thing is the impacts we're expecting. The squall line is forecast to actually strengthen as it moves through Alabama, and which is typically the opposite. So it's not expected to die down like we're kind of accustomed to. Could be producing wind gusts in excess of 70 miles an hour. So while we did, you know, somebody made a comment, well, there aren't many trees left to get knocked down. We do still have some that did not fall during Hurricane Idalia. Some that were kind of barely hanging on. And so we are concerned about trees falling. And obviously when they fall, they will fall across the road, block the transportation, they fall on power lines, so we're worried about power outages. And then obviously damage to the property, but you know, there's always the risk of trees falling on houses. So working with Mr. Barlow this afternoon, we got a press release out to make sure that everybody, she's been updating social media all through the weekend. They need to do as far as securing trampolines and outdoor furniture, those types of things, because even outside, even before the squall line gets here, one of the things that triggered, not the only thing, but one of the things that triggered the schools to make moves, they did go ahead and close. We were very concerned with school buses due to the fact that starting around daybreak, even before the thunderstorms get here, sustained winds of 30 to 35 miles an hour, gusts 45 to 50 miles an hour. So it's going to be a windy day all day tomorrow. So that those early breezes are going to squall line comes through and we kind of finish it off. There's always a threat for this. This is probably more threat than normal. The risk is a little greater. You never know where tornadoes are going to form, but basically the conditions are favorable. This entire southwest Georgia, North Florida area, so we have to be very cognizant and prepared for that, making sure that they've got plans so they know where they're going to go if they get a tornado warning is issued. You know, with very little notice, make sure that, and because safety, you know, life safety is our number one goal. And but then once the squall line moves through, it's about 3 o'clock, it's going to clear out. But the forecasters have maintained their confidence in the forecast. And outside of the official briefings, that you even called me personally, had some conversations about their concerns for what the impact is. Prepared going into, you know, I appreciate everybody's collaboration and cooperation, and again, you know, making sure that we're prepared so that we can take care of our school children, our citizens, our property, and those type of things. And if we are fortunate enough that it isn't quite as bad, then we'll enjoy, you know, we can enjoy the day off and count our blessings, but we just can't afford, especially with what we've just been through, we can't afford to discount this, especially if you have information in the data. So we're taking all the steps we can to make sure that, just like we always are, we're prepared in case there's this forecast does all the truth. So I'd answer the questions you might have.
Yes.
Ashley, are you aware of any possible shelter options for any homeless who may be out in the weather come tomorrow or anything?
So we did similar to what we did during the hurricane. I have been coordinating with a with one of the local churches. And so it's what we call shelters last resort. We're obviously encouraging people to like homeless take advantage of things like the land, the Salvation Army, those shelters that they normally would go to, even if there wasn't a storm. Those shelters are overrun or need some overflow. Also, people who may have a mobile home who don't have a suitable shelter. So you know, we're going to kind of evaluate what the situation looks like first thing in the morning. And we already have plans and the capability to very quickly turn on a shelter like that and give them somewhere to go. Forecast looks like it's going to, you know, stick for you. So just saying today.
So possibly, I guess, about 9 to 10 or something like that, you're saying that you will be able to make an announcement, hey, if you're homeless, you can go to this church.
Yes, sir. Any other questions? Ashley, again, thank you very much. You do a fantastic job in the county during these weather conditions and situations that you've had. We talked a lot about the work that you did there. Again, we owe you a tremendous amount. Thank you for what you did there and same preparedness for this. Hopefully, it'll just be something that just flows through and we'll be back up and going.